Happy Friday here from Confluence Brewing Company. We've got another beer release this week. It's our ChewBOCKa Doppelbock style, German style Doppelbock. We've got, this beer has been around. It was probably like brew number 8. Oh, Eric, what the heck? Hey, buddy.
getting into the spirit of things.
I'm feigning surprise. I knew he was going to do that. But so, yeah, long story on this one. I'll try to make it short, but it was probably batch number 8 or 10 that we did at Confluence, and we were still working out the settings on the mill and the auger. And lo and behold, we basically turned the grits into flour, and we had a stuck mash. And you know, something that I started, I think, at like 7 a.m. on one day, I finished at about 1 p.m. on the next day, because we spent about 10 hours laudering. I should say I was the only one here. And so I did take a nap in the office overnight at some point, and I set the mash kettle at, it's got some automatic controls. I set it at like 210 degrees, and it stayed there, I think it was 8 to 10 hours it was sitting at that temperature. And so the beer that we got out of that was chewy, and we needed a name for it. So it was just, I think, a simple translation to go to ChewBOCKa.
It's a chewy Bock.
Yes. So, you know, we tried not to make it the same way the next year, but we tried to make it taste the same. And I think over the years, we've made small tweaks to make it the best version of itself. And I'm proud to call this our Bock. And I think it worked out very well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, it's, I think it's a phenomenal. As a guy who, for a number of years, professionally poured German beers at a little German beer hall here in Des Moines. I got my fair share of the style, and you know, everything we do here is influenced or you know, try to be as true to the style as possible.
Exactly.
While if we see something that maybe we think we'd like to change a little bit, mm-hmm. change it up just a little tiny bit.
You bet.
But I think this does a great job of doing that. Yeah. So. If you can see, we have two different glasses. Traditionally, when we have our ChewBOCKa Fest, we kind of we start off with mugs.
Yeah.
And we kind of decided to change it in 2019 to this fun kind of, looks almost like
it's an actual Bock glass.
It's a Bock glass, yeah. It looks like the celebratory glass that you get. And then this is last year's glass, which is a lot of fun, so. But yeah, cheers.
Cheers, Eric. So as Eric mentioned, we have a thing called ChewBOCKa Fest. We try to coincide that with the beginning of Lent each year, as the monks did in Germany with, mm-hmm. I don't think they had a ChewBOCKa Fest, but they would drink their Bock during Lent, and that was really the only sustenance they had, was water and Bock. And, you know, it has, I think the Bocks of old had a little more sugar content, mm-hmm. a little more fortifying. Ours is pretty heavy duty, though, and it clocks in around 7% ABV.
Yep. You definitely still get some residual sugar, but it's not cloyingly sweet.
No.
It's not like Are We Heavy has a decent amount of sweetness, but even that, it's not too intense.
Right.
Yeah.
Good balance though with the German hops. In there.
You definitely get noble hops.
Cleans up really nice. It's got a beautiful garnet color.
Yeah. No, it really is. Yeah. I don't know if you can see the sunlight through the glass, but it's real nice. Kind of biscuity.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Lots of Munich malt.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Very enjoyable.
If you like dark beers, if you like malty, smooth, this is one for you. We did say you can taste the noble hops, but it's definitely not hoppy. It's not an IPA in any sense of the word. Obviously, it's a Bock. This is a fan favorite, and obviously, the branding is pretty fun on it too. So.
Yeah. Yeah. Very playful.
Yeah.
Make sure you check out our Bock Fest this year. Is going to be a little different. It's going to be more geared toward the take-home version. Mm-hmm. So look for a couple special packages that we can put together. I think we're working toward glassware again this year, so we keep that tradition. We've got a special other thing that we're working on that would be pretty exciting. So stay tuned.
Super secret.
Yep.
Super secret merch item. So yeah, it'll be a lot of fun. But yeah, we're unfortunately doing a socially distanced / virtual ChewBOCKa Fest this year. We're almost through this thing, and we'll get there.
We'll make the final push with virtual ChewBOCKa Fest, and hopefully get back to normal soon. Cheers.
Cheers.
Prost.